Oh, I am absolutely loving the show today. So much valuable information and so much for us to take away from and invest in these beautiful bodies we've been blessed with. But now, to carry on with the conversation, every year, nearly 120,000 South Africans are diagnosed with cancer. And while there are so many factors that contribute to your risk of cancer, we can help to reduce that risk by making better lifestyle and diet choices. Now, here to talk to us about the importance of food in cancer-fighting diet is Cancer's consulting dietitian, Megan Pence-Klates, and she's coming onto the show to educate us. And Meg, I can't thank you enough for joining us. How are you doing this morning?
It's lovely to be here. No, very well, thank
you. Last conversation with the team was on Zoom, right?
So it was. It's been a while.
It's good to have you in the flesh and to
really
feel your energy.
It's really good to be here.
But let's talk about the basics first. Cancer. Organization. What does it mean and what is it about and your involvement in it exactly?
I've been involved with the Cancer Association of South Africa since 2006, where I've been consulting to them as a dietitian for cancer. And it's a great organization. You know, it actually gives out, it supports people with cancer, families with cancer. You know, you can actually go onto their website, cancer.org.za, and any type of advice that you need, you can connect with them via email, and they'll also assist you further. So it's been a really great journey where we've actually, you know, kept up to date with all the evidence regarding nutrition and cancer.
Yeah, and nutrition for me is such a big, passionate facet of my life, especially the amount of things I've been learning, number one. And then number two, I almost have this belief of dietitians to me in my world are almost more valuable than doctors. And I say this on live TV very carefully though, because prevention's better than cure, right? I'm getting lots of evil stares from the doctors. There's a lot of doctors in the building right now. They're not liking me.
Keep it coming.
But honestly though, for me, prevention's better than cure. But what is your take when it comes to using food to fight or potentially prevent cancer?
Yes, so you know, there's only so many things we can do, and it's one of the modifiable factors. In other words, one of those lifestyle factors we have the ability to change.
Yeah.
So we can change our risk. And diet plays an incredibly important role in being able to do that. So by making better choices in terms of the foods that we choose, just to give you an example, if we look specifically at whole foods and we look at plant foods in particular. Mm. So now you're looking at, particularly if you look at things like your greens are great, your broccolis, your leafy greens, and then you start looking at, just mentioning a couple, like you've got your citrus fruits, those are really important. And then of course, as well, looking at the omega-3 and cancer,
good
and
fats,
then you can bring in your good fats, which is, incorporates not only your oily fish, but it also incorporates things like your canola oil, your olive oil, etc.
Now, you've done something incredible with BeWell, right? Not only do they have some incredible information on the website, but you've developed a conscious cookbook, if I'm not mistaken, right?
That's right.
Which talks to this exact point. It talks about upgrading our lifestyle, how we fuel ourselves. Tell me more about this.
It was a really exciting project. So what I also know from my years of experience is people want something that's simple, that's South African based, and that can also, be for the family. And that was my basis that I worked on. And of course, I made sure that the way that it was done is that the entire family could eat from it.
Okay.
So it's a really great, and it's available to everyone. I've looked at different breakfasts, different lunches, different dinners, because that's one of the most important things is people skip meals. And that's a big problem.
Yes.
And then also, better snacks. So I've incorporated all those different options. And of course, I think it's important we must look, today specifically at cost.
Yes.
So I've taken that into consideration as well. So you're welcome to actually download for free the recipe book.
Oh, really?
And to make use of it.
Doesn't cost a cent. What excuse do we have then? I love that.
And it's really simple. And what's also we've done with each recipe is we've indicated how easy or how hard it is. So that you can also, just decide.
So you're feeling like a challenge, ones. You can go for something
That's
extreme,
it.
But it sounds
exactly.
like it's something that the kids might love. And for me, it's about looking forward to your meals, but also not that it's an unhealthy meal, it's something that is actually fundamentally fueling you for the right purpose. Now, you mentioned some of the foods that are good examples. Tell me some of the bad examples, some of the things we should maybe stay away from when it comes to preventing and getting this cancer thing out of our lives.
Yes, and I think sometimes that's perhaps a little bit more of a challenge.
Yeah.
Because we tend to look at foods, and when we look at foods that are very very processed, so processing itself is not bad. So if you look at processing, you're looking at something like if you cook something, there's a certain level of processing that takes place. But the moment you ultra process something, where you take out a lot of the fiber and the goodness and you put in, you know, back lots of fat and sugar, then you get these ultra-processed, high, you know, energy foods with lack of nutrients, and those are the ones that are a problem.
Okay. Well, look, Megan, I'm loving this conversation. I'm loving everything that you're feeding us, and I'm loving the fact that we can download a free conscious cookbook on the BeWell website. That's bewell.co.za, correct?
100%.
You guys at home, Zanzi, you definitely want to get involved in this. Obviously, it's got some incredible opportunities for you to upgrade your body. Before we even speak about that, I've got one more question for you. I've been hearing so many myths, people coming through on our social media channels. There's myths about olive oil being bad when it's heated. Do you have some ideas with regards to these myths, some of the things that just, like, don't worry about it, Mzanzi. The specialist is here to kind of console things for us. Example, the olive oil myth.
Sure.
What's going on there?
Okay, so one thing that happens is when you heat oil, the potential is if you heat it to a very high heat, it actually can, there's chemical bonds that hold things together and they can break.
Okay.
And when they break, then they go from being a really good oil with lots of good nutritional value to a bad oil. So it goes from what we call a cis form to a trans form, and the trans fats are bad.
Yes.
But that's a certain heat. So when you're looking at olive oil, for example, and your canola oils and so on, especially when you're doing a little bit, you remember we don't advocate deep frying, but if you're just doing a little bit of shallow frying, your temperature, you know, in your pan is going to be around about 160, 180 degrees. And your olive oil actually can go up to that point of what we call the smoking point, where it becomes a bit of a problem, only when it reaches around about 210, 220
okay.
degrees.
And we're generally not cooking at that heat, right?
No. So you remember, if you are going to, then you want to go over to something like your canola. Mm. But that would be maybe more, you know, long-term roasting in the oven. But otherwise, you can definitely use your
Megan, coming through with the good stuff, educating us all. I can't thank you enough for joining us this morning.
Pleasure.
I look forward to our next conversations, because it only means good things. And for you, I hope you enjoy the rest of the day. But for you, Mzanzi, if you are struggling to make healthy food, and this cookbook is honestly such a great guide to get you going. And speaking of food, Megan's going to be showing us how to make one of these books' delicious dishes right after the break, so stay tuned.